some sort of connection between, you know, rotating superconductor anti-gravity research and this idea.
Quit eating your babies.
And so I began investigating.
Freaking weirdos.
First, that's what drew me to initially to the.
He's chasing his baby. Going after one little baby, too.
Made me instantly realize that, you know, this was, you know, metamaterials are used for invisibility technology, and that I started, you know, realizing all the technology that, you know, that all the research that had been done on an Area 51, Project Rainbow, all this other stuff, and I was able to confirm that a lot of those, these materials were, in fact, you know, something special, and that, you know, there was an ordinary staff sergeant from the military.
Watch him, he's chasing all them. It's not like I don't feed him. He's a cannibal.
No, it was virtually unheard of. In fact, a lot of the physics literature, you can't find a lot of metamaterials. You can't find a lot of stuff in the literature on metamaterials or quasicrystals before 2002. And then Fouché was talking about these things in 1998, nearly 4 years earlier. So that sort of, you know, really made me say, wow, this is something. I started researching quasicrystals, you know, I realized that the guy who discovered quasicrystals, Dan Shechtman, did his postdoc after receiving his materials degree in material science from Technion University in Israel. He went and did his postdoc at Wright-Patterson, so at the Wright State Materials Command, which is the exact place where, you know, we'd expect these sort of alien materials to be, you know, to be present and being analyzed. So I thought that was a very interesting that the scientist who discovered quasicrystals did some work to Wright-Patterson Material Command on icosahedral phase crystals and stuff. So it was quite interesting to learn about that. Then, of course, if you research all the history of metamaterials, you'll find that these were developed pretty much in Area 51. It was a lot of pioneering research into metamaterials and magnetic resonance and EMF response. Those technologies were pioneered at Area 51. Again, metamaterial is an interesting word. It's basically a metamaterial for the layman is a material that gains its resonant or response properties through its structure, not through its composition or what it's made of, but by just the natural structuring of the actual material. So it was discovered that grids, for example, had a different response, or things with sharp edges had a different response than smooth edges and rounded edges, which is why you see all those sharp edges on the F-117 stealth fighter versus, you know, the round edges on the fuselage and the quasicrystals, because that was some deep insight into some interesting information, and how he knew about that and how he was aware. Still trying to figure that out, and I, you know, I think it might have been he might have knew Hal Puthoff and might have gotten the information through Hal Puthoff. That was one contact I know that he had, because he talked about Hal Puthoff, and actually had his email and put me in touch with Hal Puthoff years ago at one point. So I know that he had some of these contacts who were into this black world physics stuff. So a quasi crystal is an aperiodic crystal. It has a different phase. It has recurring symmetries, but it doesn't have innate symmetry at the basic level. It has a more complex symmetry shape. So they were originally thought not to exist. In fact, one of the most famous scientists of the day, Linus Pauling, you know, once famously claimed there's no such thing as quasi-crystals, only quasi-scientists, making that, you know, a direct, you know, jab at Daniel Shechtman, who's, of course, the scientist that made this discovery and won the Nobel Prize for the discovery of quasicrystals. Also, quasicrystals have very amazing optical properties, which is one of the light in a in photonics, in a type of advanced circuitry. So that was what I first saw and started learning about when I first researched these things back in 2004, and I immediately, you know, realized that, you know, we're dealing with something very close to alien technology, what I believe alien technology would look like, you know, described as we think of it.